बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप ऑल ऑफ़ यू विल बी फाइन एंड डूइंग वेल। आई एम योर साइंस टीचर विद साइंस बुक ऑफ लेवल 4 एंड वी आर ऑलरेडी इन द यूनिट नंबर 4 एंड वी आर इन द टॉपिक। दैट टॉपिक नेम इज़ द करेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ द लिविंग थिंग्स। वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस द करेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द लिविंग थिंग्स इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर एंड द थ्री करेक्टरिस्टिक्स आर लेफ्ट विच वी विल डिस्कस इन दिस lecture, which is on book page number 32 and 33. One of the most important characteristic of the living thing is that all living things have sensitivity. Sensitivity means feeling. Living things respond or react to the things which happens in their environment. Living things respond to the stimuli. When we touch a hot thing, we immediately draw our hand. When we touch the hot object, we immediately draw our hand. Why it is so? When we touch the hot object, the hotness of the object, when we touch, this is the stimulus, and when we feel the heat, the hotness of the object, this is the response. We immediately remove our hand. So what is the stimulus and what is response? Stimuli, a change in the environment that causes a living being to change is known as stimulus. And what is response? The change in the living being caused by the stimulus is known as response. When we touch the hot object, we feel what? The hotness of the object. This is the stimulus. When we touch the hot object, this is the stimulus. When we feel the heat, we immediately draw our hand. This is the response. Same like the animal, plant also have sensitivity. Plant also show sensitivity. One of the most important plant is the mimosa plant. What we call mimosa plant? Mimosa plant is also called touch me not. When we touch the leaf of mimosa plant, the plant leaf close up. The touching of the leaf is the stimulus, and the response of the plant is what? Closing of leaf. This is the response. So one of the most important plant in the world is touch me not, which show sensitivity. And the other most important characteristic of the living thing is that our living things can reproduce. It is the basic characteristics of the living things. Living organism reproduce to give birth to the organism of own kind. Like microbes, even the microbes also reproduce to increase its number. For example, bacteria, which causes disease in our body. Some animals giving birth by laying eggs, while some animals give birth to the live babies. Like hen given birth to the chick by laying eggs, cow giving birth to the calf by live babies. Living things can reproduce, but non-living things doesn't reproduce. Like what? Like robot. You see the robot. Robot is non-living things. Robot can move. It can work. It can run by the electricity. But robot cannot breathe. Cannot eat the food. Robot cannot give birth to the baby robot, because all living things can reproduce, but non-living things can not reproduce. So we can say that living things are made up of cell, and non-living things are made up of matter, and matter is made up of molecules. Cell can reproduce to make new cell, but non-living things cannot reproduce. You know that all living things need food for which purposes? For getting energy. And energy is utilized to grow and to work, to alive. All living things grow and go through a life process. What is life cycle? A life cycle. All living organisms having limited lifespan, and finally all of them dies some days. Animals do not having special growing points. The body of the animals grows. It keeps on growing as it is its parents. And how the growth is happening in animals? In animals, cells, nails, hairs are grow. In the plants, the tip of stem, root, leaves have special group of cell which keep on dividing. A plant grows at the tip. How the growth is happening in the plant? In the plant, the root and stems are grow. For example, if we put the bean seed in a soil, after some days the bean seeds grow up. If we same experiments we do, if we put pencil or a wire in the soil, after some days there will be no growth. So we can say that living things can grow but non-living things cannot grow. I hope you understood this lecture. Thank you.